Hello, good morning everyone. On today's video, we are going to talk about the pullbacks, different setups that we can create, and mainly how to detect a pullback and how to enter in the market. It looks simple, but there are a lot of ways to enter the market. Let's see, for example, this chart of Standard & Poor's. Here we have a moving average. Let's say that we want to enter on a pullback to that moving average. This method works for any line, but on this example, we will check how to enter into that moving average. One question is how to define if we want to enter and which side. For example, here we may be not interested in doing nothing. And one thing that we can see is that the slope of the entry line is almost horizontal. And when we finally have a slope on the entry line, then the market is moving. So now we may be interested in a retracement to that moving average. The idea is to get a bounce over that line. Another thing that we can take into account, and more evident if the bars are bigger, is that when the market is on sideways, we have a lot of bars touching the line. So we have very little space, like these holes here, between the bars and the entry line. Instead, when the market is moving, we have a lot of space between both the price and the entry line. So at some point, we will have a pullback to the moving average. So here we have a long. We have several entries, and at some point, the market reverses. Here, for example, we have a short, and now we have a long, and another short. How to decide when we want to enter long or short? That will be the main question. And also, how to avoid that on the final reversal, we don't get a loss. If we are always entering the line, at some point, here, for example, this may be a losing trade unless we have a big stop. But at some point, for example, here, this is a loser trade. One way to avoid that is, again, by the slope of the line. It is almost horizontal. Here, instead, we have a slightly positive slope. But another way is, let's view first the different entry methods. For example, here we are looking for a long, so we can place a buy limit over the line and keep updating the entry price each bar while the entry moves, until we have a fill, and if the stop is big enough, then we get the target. The problem is when the market finally reverses, then even having a big stop, we have a loser. Here, for example, if we place a buy limit, we get a fill and we get a stop out on the entry. So we cannot avoid the last trade when the trend finishes. Another method would be to wait for a bar touching, so we don't place any order. And when this bar is painting and the price is below the entry line, we can define a threshold and we place a buy stop order. At the following bar, we get a fill, and then we get the target. We don't need a big stop on this entry, because once the market goes in the final direction, the pivot is already defined, so we can place our stop below that pivot. Now, there are another bar types where this method is even simpler. Let's see, for example, Unirenco. Each candle has three parameters, where we define the offset, the trend, and the reversal. The trend is the number of ticks that the price must move in the same direction to paint a new bar of the same color. The reversal is one of the most important settings, is how many ticks the price must move in the opposite direction to paint a new bar of different color. So with the reversal, we filter the noise in the price. And finally, the offset. The offset is the distance between the close and the open, the fake open. The open on this bar is fake. And with these three parameters, we can get a lot of different configurations. For example, let's say that we leave only the reversal big enough to filter, and then we make the trend one, so each candle is only one tick higher than or lower than the previous, and the offset also, if instead of six ticks we set this to one, then we get this configuration where the wicks of the candles are very useful to enter on a pullback. If we make the moving average faster, we get this almost straight line, even if it is a moving average, and we get very good entries. If we look at this chart, it looks like all the entries are good, because let's say here we have a short, here we don't have any signal, here we have a short, also with a target, a long with a target. So it looks like all the trades are good, but we have to take into account two facts. One is the entry method. When we enter into this trade, it depends on the entry method. When we are on this candle, we are at the close, so we are here, then decide to enter long. So if we use a buy limit order, it is possible that the wick is too big, so we are stopped out. And if we use another method, let's say that we wait for an offset to break that line, and now we wait for a crossover to the upside. When that happens, we get a fill near the moving average, and of course, if the following bar is green, then we get a fill. But if at the moment we get a fill, the price moves again back, this is something that we cannot see by looking at the bar, then we may get stopped out, unless we use a very big stop again. But usually, we don't need a big stop on that case. But now we have another problem on the reversals. Here we are waiting at the close of that bar and we want to enter long at this place. But instead of placing a buy limit, if we place a buy limit, this is a losing trade for sure. But if instead we wait for the price to cross that line and then we wait for a crossover to the upside, that crossover maybe don't happen because the price keeps going down and never comes back to give us a fill. No, no, that not don't. This doesn't always happen because the price not always enters from the open and exit on the close, because it may goes to the trigger, then goes back, so we get a fill, and then keeps going down and closes the bar. So in that case, we will get a fill and a loser. It is not easy to see on the chart, but sometimes that may happen. So we must have into account those two facts. Not all the signals may be good as they look, and also on the reversals, maybe if the reversal is not fast, then we may get a fill and a stop out. Let's see an example. Something that we may notice is that the price, the entry price, is moving. Let's say that we place a sell limit, the first method. And
order
we can
filled.
See that the price moves. So we may get a fill, and when the bar closes, the entry doesn't match with our fill. This is because the entry is moving. To avoid that, we need to set the line, the entry line, with calculate at bar close set to true. That will be a moving average of 10. And this parameter, calculate on bar close set to true. So let me remove the previous line. So now we can see that the entry price gets fixed. It doesn't move while the price is moving. So let's see how we enter on this trade manually. So let's go to 11:15. To avoid placing a sell limit, we wait for the bar to reach a higher than the entry line. So this may be a possible entry. So now we have two options. The entry price was this value. So we can place a sell limit at that level, a sell stop,
order
sorry.
Pending.
And let's see what happens. If the price fires to the upside,
order
then
filled.
We don't get a fill, and also
target
we don't get
filled.
A loser. In this case, we got a fill, and that was a winner. Another method is just waiting and enter manually. Let's wait for the following signal. Now on this bar we have a very big high, so a limit entry is possible that will be stopped out. And now we have the decision. The
order filled.
Price is below, so we can enter at market because the high was over the line, and the close is below. So now I can use a stop very
target
much
filled.
More smaller. So we get a worst fill, but we are sure that the market is going in the same direction that we want to trade. Here we know that that was a losing trade because here we have a reversal. If we have a limit order pending, then we will get a fill. But now I am waiting for the close to be below the line to press to trigger the sell market. If the price never come back, then I am sure that I am not entering on the brown trade, and that will be an example. On the following video, we will see how to create this setup using Markers tools to create the signals and also to automate the setup as we have on this template. If you have Marker Plus, you can download this template from the website. This is the MP65 pullback, and you get the signals. The signals are painted at the exact tick the price crosses the moving average. So you should get a fill near that line. And we don't need a big stop, because usually when the price crosses the line, the high was already made. This will be seen on the following video. Hope this video has been useful for you, and if you have any question, please post below. Thank you, everyone. Bye bye.